Hey guys, today for the review, we have the WEP 948D3. We received this soldering and desoldering station from the WEP Tools company to make a review. It's the WEP 948D, the III Soldering plus Desoldering 2-in-1 station. This device functions as a soldering station and a desoldering station, unlike many other devices that serve exclusively as one or the other. First, we will unbox it and assess its features. This integrated soldering and desoldering station is available through the link provided in the video description. It's time to see what's inside this box. The station is housed in a sturdy metal case with ventilation on the sides and the back. On the back is the connector where you plug the power cord and the on and off switch for the station. On the top is a strap, so you can safely and easily carry the station. This metallic device is the holder for the soldering and desoldering guns. There is a power cord where you attach it to the back of the station. There is a soldering gun. Connect the circular male connector to the female connector on the left side. Tighten the connector. These connectors are attached to the desoldering gun. Connect the circular male connector to the female connector on the right side. Tighten the connector. Connect the vacuum tube to the vacuum receptacle cover. The desoldering gun comes with two interchangeable soldering sucker nozzles. This one is the 1 mm nozzle. On the back, there is the filter chamber. To detach the soldering holder, press the blue button downward. The soldering holder consists of a retainer, a filter spring, two ceramic filters, and a clear solder residue storage chamber. There is another soldering sucker nozzle. This one is a 1.2 millimeter nozzle. To replace the nozzle, loosen the tube enclosure. Afterwards, you can easily slide off the nozzle from the heating element. Let's see what additional accessories this bag contains. This is a long cleaning pin for cleaning the inside of the desoldering gun so it doesn't get clogged. These are extra ceramic filters and carbon filters to put inside the soldering holder. This is another long cleaning pin. There are two extra filter springs. There is an extra filter chamber. There is an extra vacuum receptacle cover. There is a set of cleaning tips if you have different nozzle sizes. They're all attached in a ring, which is convenient. Remove the plastic cover from the LCD. When not in use, place the soldering and desoldering guns into the metallic holder. There is a sponge for cleaning the soldering tip. Toggle the power switch on the back of the station. Press the left power button to turn on the soldering tool. The temperature increases very quickly. Let's find out the maximum temperature. Maximum temperature is 896 degrees Fahrenheit or 480 degrees Celsius. The minimum temperature is 392 degrees Fahrenheit or 200 degrees Celsius. Let's see how long it takes to lower the temperature. It takes a bit more time to lower the temperature than to increase it. press the power button on the right side to turn on the desoldering tool. The lowest temperature is 716 degrees Fahrenheit or 380 degrees Celsius. The highest temperature is 896 degrees Fahrenheit or 480 degrees Celsius. Similar to the soldering tool, it takes a bit of time to lower the temperature. If you want to move the station, it makes it very easy having this strap. Press and hold the menu button to toggle the LCD display. Press the plus or minus button to switch from Fahrenheit to Celsius. There are two additional accessories included with this product. The first is a grounding wire, used to absorb excess electricity and prevent electric shock by directing it into the ground. To use it properly, insert the connector to the back of the station. Attach the alligator clip to a grounded object or a surface with high electrical resistance. The second accessory is a heat-resistant silicone pad. You can tie the pad to one of the cords by looping the arrow end of the pad into the hole and creating a tie. This pad is designed to reduce heat when handling heated components like tightening the fastener of the soldering or desoldering gun. As you can see, I have the soldering gun set to 350 degrees Celsius and the desoldering gun set to 380 degrees Celsius. I don't feel the heat while touching the pad. For your safety, I would still wait until the soldering or desoldering gun has cooled down before attempting to adjust the fasteners. It's time to test out this equipment. Turn on the desoldering station. Wait for the temperature to reach 380 degrees Celsius, and the green light has turned on before using the desoldering station. As you can see, the desoldering gun isn't ready for use yet until you see the green light. Once you hear the beep and see the green light, you can start using the desoldering tool. I have a capacitor that I want to remove from this printed circuit board or PCB. Add some solder wire to the tip of the nozzle. The solder wire isn't included with the station, but if you want to know which one I use, I have a link to it in the video description. Press the nozzle tip to the through hole and leave it there for a few seconds to melt the solder. Press the trigger of the desoldering gun. Within a few seconds, the solder is removed from the through hole. Add more solder wire to the nozzle tip. Press the nozzle tip to the other hole. Press the trigger of the desoldering gun. The tweezer isn't included with the station, but I have a link in the video description of the one that I used. Let's see if I can remove a transistor from this PCB. Add some solder wire to the tip of the nozzle. Press the nozzle tip to the through hole and leave it there for a few seconds to melt the solder. Press the trigger of the desoldering gun. That's very quick and easy. Do the same process for the other two holes. Now let's test the soldering station. I will reverse the process and solder the transistor back to the PCB. Insert the transistor to the through hole. Touch the soldering gun to the transistor wire. Touch the solder wire to the soldering gun. Once the solder melts and cover the hole, you can move to the next hole. Repeat until you have completed soldering all three holes. This is a great tool. Since it can solder and desolder with one station, it makes soldering and desoldering jobs so much easier. As you've seen, it heats up very quickly. The desoldering tool makes it very easy to remove components from a PCB. I've tried other desoldering tools, and this is a lot easier. The price is very reasonable. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.